how do you make a song? Well, you maybe have like a melody or like an idea that you cannot get out of your head. Then you spend weeks writing lyrics that speak your truth without being too cringy. You create beats, harmonies, and dissonances before everything comes together as if they were always meant to be one single unit. What if AI could now make my perfect song with just few prompts? Let's find out.
Hi, my name's Ana Morales, and I'm a PhD student at EPFL. In this video, I'm teaming up with EPFL and Vision Rain Science Film Studio to make a song for my main YouTube channel, Size Matters. Our song's gonna have two basic elements. These are lyrics and music, and we're gonna ask two AI art generators to produce both of these elements for us. While we're making the song, we will speak to people at EPFL who are actually doing research on AI, and hopefully we'll get a better understanding of this technology that is changing the world. To make the lyrics, we will use ChatGPT, which is a text generator. It's really popular. And we will start by giving it a prompt so that it can try or start trying to emulate or mimic one of my favorite artists. ChatGPT has been trained with huge amounts of text information from the internet. For example, essays or questions and answers or entire books. These are the training sets. The algorithms or rules that make this generator use interconnected information centers known as neurons. The connections between them all create what we know as a neural network. When we give it an input through a question or a prompt, it uses all the information that it has been trained on in order to create a response that mimics human behavior, but with way more information than a real human being could really obtain. In this case, we ask it to produce a song for us. This is our input. ChatGPT has been trained on millions of songs with different artists, genres, styles, and it uses this information to create an output for us. This output is a unique set of lyrics influenced by the training sets that we mentioned earlier. Okay, so on one hand, I was pretty amazed by the power of ChatGPT. Like, I even asked it to write the script for a video that I potentially will make in the future, and it gave me something pretty great. But I think that it gave me that, like, in a very eloquent fashion, because it was very factual. But if you asked it to make a song, then it gets a bit cringier. Like, it was, for example, it was using the word we all the time, you know? Anyway, it did come up with a song, and you're gonna listen to it with lyrics and all later at the end of the video. So once the lyrics were done and we were kind of happy with them, it was time for us to try and make music. So for the music, we tried to use several AI music generators, but we found that Ava was giving us something that we really like. This AI works in a similar way to ChatGPT. It was trained on lots of different music, and it uses that to generate new music from an input. Both Ava and ChatGPT use something called reinforcement learning. I had a chat at EPFL with someone who studies the intricacies of this process.
Yeah, so my name is Sophia, and I'm a PhD student at EPFL at the moment. So I work in the intersection of reinforcement learning and neuroscience. So basically the idea is that we try to take insights from neuroscience and transfer them into algorithms to make algorithms be more effective and learn in ways that are more natural, like the brain. And at the same time, we basically use insights from reinforcement learning to then understand better what could be going on in the brain. So what is reinforcement learning? In maybe one sentence, you can say it's the way how algorithms or artificial agents would learn by interacting with the environment. So it's a bit different. You don't give them the exact solution to a problem. For example, you don't tell them, oh, move your arm like this to grab the object, but you let them try out by themselves. So it's very similar to like human trial and error. You can imagine if you're a baby and you want to try and grab an object, that's very similar to a robot agent trying to just grab an object from the table, put it up, and keep it in his hand, for example. So the whole thing is interacting with the environment and learning from the rewards. So did I grab the object, yes or no? Was that successful, yes or no? But there's actually a bit of an issue with this, because there are so many possible ways how the robot could move the arm. You know, if you have sparse rewards, in the sense that you don't have lots of rewards, and you should try out a lot of different actions before you actually make a successful thing, for example, before you manage to reach the object, then how should you choose the actions in between? And that sometimes makes reinforcement agents at the moment a bit inefficient. And that's why, for example, what I work on is intrinsic motivations. So what I work on is novelty seeking, which means that you preferably gonna try out the stuff that you haven't tried yet. And that can be an intrinsic motivation for agents, but we also know that humans, and especially babies, use it a lot. Like every baby would be like, oh, look, it's a novel object. Or when it starts to walk, it would be trying out the things that it hasn't tried out yet. So that's one of the current topics in RL that I'm working on.
As opposed to words or prompts like we did with ChatGPT, what we did this time is set the parameters of the song. So for example, length, beats per minute, mood or style.
In Ava, we simply click on create track and then select the kind of music style that we are going for. In this case, I'm mostly interested in a relaxing song that is not too intense for the viewer. So I think that I'm searching for something like lo-fi ambient, I guess. Then it requests us to input a key signature, let's try F minor, for example, a duration, let's say between 30 seconds and 1 minute, and the number of songs. If I put 3, it will give me 3 songs. Now, as you can see here, I have more than 3 songs because I've been playing with Ava more. So I have a lot of songs here. So let me show you a couple of the ones that I'm thinking are the best. This one. I love it. I really like it because it's kind of a mixture between lo-fi and synthwave, but I think it sounds a little bit too dark. Then we have this one that I actually think is pretty good, but the one that I think we're gonna use is actually this one. I don't know if you could hear, but there was something going on, like, and the only problem with this song at the time is that this melody is very repetitive. It was pretty repetitive. It was doing all of the time. So we decided to edit the song, which you can do in Ava, and you can tweak it. So you can tweak each instrument differently as you want. And what we did was removing some of these annoying. So yeah, we basically decided to go for this song, but also edited slightly with Ava itself. Once we got something that we liked, we called Fabian because he handles the sound in Bizin Rain, and we wanted to get a sense of direction, maybe also like a sense of if these lyrics and song actually match together and if he could actually pull out a song from this. And then with the okay from Fabs, we just needed to record myself singing. There are ways to produce singing with AI, but we decided that the best way to give this project a personal touch was for me to complete the song by singing myself. Okay, so here we are. We have the final song, which I haven't heard yet because as of now, Fabs is still mixing it or working with it. So it was easy actually with AI to produce things, but not as easy to produce things that we like. However, I'm still overwhelmed and excited as well, I guess, about using AI as a tool. Don't forget to subscribe to EPFL's YouTube channel. You can also subscribe to mine, Size Matters. I gotta say though that it's in Spanish, so there's that. Enjoy the song, we'll see. I'm also curious, we haven't heard it either. Let me know what you think, if it's good or if it's crappy, and see you soon.